We talk a lot about speakers on this channel, mostly on how to build them, but once they're built or bought, you still have another step. Passive speakers need to be powered. Of course, there are plenty of options to choose from, and it can get a little complicated depending on your budget and the features that you're looking for. I'm gonna continue walking you through the amps that come across my listening setup, and I think I've got a good one for you this time, a good sounding amp with a balanced assortment of features. Hey everyone, I'm Kirby, this is Kirby Meets Audio, and today we're gonna talk about the Dayton Audio DTA-120BT Bluetooth audio amp. As you might expect, I've used quite a few budget amps, but there's been one that I've recommended literally for years. I think I picked it up for the first time in like 2014, and I still have that original amp and I still use it from time to time. That amp was the DTA-120, full stop. Sound familiar? I don't know if you can call it a predecessor, maybe more like a brother to the DTA-120BT, but let's talk about specs on these two amps. Both push 60 watts with a 4-ohm load, which is plenty of power for most speakers. And as just a little aside for a second, I think some people get a little too caught up in wanting as many watts as they can get in their audio amps. Watts isn't a great indicator of how good an amp is, and I'm pretty confident most listeners aren't using anywhere close to max output of even a reasonably powered amp like this one. Not a great, but a better indicator of an amp's quality is THD, or total harmonic distortion. And in the case of these amps, we're talking about a THD of under 0.01% at about 30 to 40 watts, and that's great. You would really have to crank this guy and upset some neighbors to hear distortion with this amp. As far as inputs and outputs, both amps feature a front mount 3.5 millimeter aux input, rear RCA input, a full quarter inch headphone output with an included adapter for 3.5 millimeter headphones, and of course your speaker outputs with nice screw binding posts that accept banana plugs. They also both come with a great assortment of connection accessories. And this is where things begin to split for these two amps. The big one is right in the name, BT or Bluetooth. This new amp offers a wireless input connection via Bluetooth 4.2 with aptX. The second big difference is the original version uses a Class T topology, while the new amp uses Class D. I have a video on comparing the sound of Class T versus Class D. You can actually watch that right up here and come up with your own conclusions. But both amp classes are digital switching amps, and although I think there is technically a difference between the two classes, the new Class D version uses a quality chip, and I can't really hear a difference. Class T amps are becoming a little rare though. I don't believe they're actually making those chips anymore, so if you do want a Class T amp, you might want to pick up this original. So I've had the new Bluetooth version of this amp hooked up to my listening setup for a while now, and just to be straight up, I'm real happy with it. I basically have two listening modes that I personally can switch into. Basically either convenience or experience. I like to listen to music while I do computer work, like designing a new pair of speakers, or when Jen and I are just hanging out around the house and maybe getting some chores done. And that's when convenience is most important to me. And having the option of a wireless input via Bluetooth so I can change songs or adjust volume right from my pocket makes the whole experience better. But then there are times that I want to sit down and relax and experience one of my favorite records. And getting up and turning over the record and engaging with my listening setup is part of the enjoyment I get out of the experience. This amp offers a really seamless way to go between those two modes that doesn't take anything away from either experience. Another great feature is just how small it is. If you aren't looking for this to be your main listening amp in a living room, it makes for probably one of the best amps you can buy for your desk. Thanks to its external power supply, it takes up very little room for how much power it actually puts out. And being able to switch between speakers and plugging in your headphones, if you want to get real personal with your music, is a great touch for this price point. Speaking of price, right now you can get the DTA-120BT on sale at Parts Express for about 76 bucks. I think it's normally around $90, while the original DTA-120 is gonna run you $99. I think that has something to do with the Class T chip. I also have a discount code just for you guys. You can find it down in the description. I try to give you guys honest and balanced reviews, but I just don't really have that many negative things to say about this amp. I guess if you don't like digital amps, you should probably stay away from this guy, or maybe some people might think 60 watts per channel is underpowered, but I would disagree. Maybe if this amp had a sub output, that would be nice, but you can't really knock it for something it's clearly not trying to be. And you can always route the speaker outs through a powered subwoofer. This is honestly one of the best all-in-one integrated amps you can buy. I mean, that's why I've been recommending the original version of this amp for years, and this guy just adds features on top of that. So I really have no problem recommending this amp if you're looking for a simple yet quality amp for your home or desk listening setup for under $100. This video is sponsored by Warby Parker. If you also wear glasses, you know how crazy expensive a good pair can be. To fix this, Warby Parker cuts out the middlemen to bring you glasses starting at $95, including prescription lenses. Lenses also include anti-glare and anti-scratch coatings, but one of my favorite things from Warby Parker is their free at-home try-on program. You pick your five favorite pairs of glasses, and a few days later, they show up to your house to try on for 5 days. There's no obligation to buy, and the shipping is free, and they include a prepaid return label. Head to warbyparker.com/KMA to order your free home try-on today. Have an iPhone X? After you head over to warbyparker.com/KMA and pick up your home try-on kit, make sure to download Warby Parker's app where you can use their brand new feature, Find Your Fit. Find Your Fit uses the iPhone X's True Depth camera to map and measure your key facial features. Using these measurements, Find Your Fit recommends approximately 12 Warby Parker frames that are likely to best fit your face. The process is seamless and takes only a few seconds. And you can feel good when you order. For every pair you buy, a pair is given to someone in need. So head over to warbyparker.com/KMA to get your free home try-on kit. And which pair did you guys like the best? Huh? If you're interested in building a pair of speakers of your own, you can head over to kmakits.com where you can find free build plans and complete build kits available for purchase. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you hated it, you know, thumbs down. Just express yourself. If you're new here and you like this video, please hit that subscription button, then hit that little bell next to it if you want updates on when I post videos. Did you know I have shirts? I have shirts. You can find them right below this video or there's a link in the description. I also have a Patreon where fans like you help me make videos like this one. And if you want to see the behind the scenes of making these videos or my speaker building or just my life in general, hit me up on Instagram. Just search Kirby Meets Audio or there's a link down in the description. All right, thanks for watching, guys. This is a good amp. I was serious when I said it. I like it. All right, I'll see you guys next week, later this week. I don't know. My schedule's been weird lately, but I'll see you soon. All right, bye.